50 years ago, Don Juan was, in the slang of the day, the cat's pajamas. People lined up to pay a record $10 to see the first full-length motion picture with a synchronized musical background. Don Juan represented the passing of one era and the birth of another. It starred John Barrymore and Mary Astor. To discuss the significance of this first commercial movie with sound, we have with us today Miles Kreuger, president of the Institute of the American Musical. Miles is the man who put together the 50th anniversary tribute to Vitaphone. Miles, what is Vitaphone exactly?
Vitaphone was a word that Warner Brothers coined in 1926 to designate its sound system that was devised actually by Western Electric and Bell Telephone. It was a method of recording sound for motion pictures on discs, 16 or 12-inch phonograph records, unlike the optical soundtracks and magnetic soundtracks that are on film today.
Well, if we're talking about synchronization, why doesn't Don Juan include any speech or conversation?
Actually, originally, the Warner Brothers felt that they wanted to use Vitaphone to standardize the level of sound recording of orchestral accompaniment for silent pictures. You see, a big city like New York or Detroit or Chicago would have a symphony orchestra accompanying a silent motion picture in a downtown theater. Then by the time the same movie got to a small town, a small village, it might be played, the score might be played on a broken down piano with the local school teacher playing away, and she might be perfectly awful. And the Warners felt that to stabilize the quality of music accompaniment, they would use phonograph records. And so on the first motion picture, they had the New York Philharmonic, no less, accompanying Don Juan.
So they really weren't interested in conversation at that time?
Not at all. It wasn't even a thought in their mind.
Is there any one scene in Don Juan that is most significant in terms of synchronization?
Well, toward the end of the picture, John Barrymore, who plays Don Juan, rescues his beloved Mary Astor from the clutches of the Borgias, and he starts to duel with Montague Love, and the clicking of the swords in the dueling sequence actually was a very historic moment, because you hear the sound effects of the clicking of the swords.
How did you start putting together this tribute to this motion picture technique?
Well, about 2 years ago, I went to United Artists and asked them why this historic program of Don Juan and the 8 Vitaphone shorts that accompanied it originally was simply unavailable, because I felt that college students, film scholars everywhere would be very interested in seeing it. It's a piece of theater and film history that you read about all the time, but you never get a chance to see. And I was told that the films were lost, and that was, to me, like throwing down the gauntlet. You see, if the films were lost, it was my obligation to find them. So I spent 2 years hunting and searching for them, and found many but not all of the films in the Library of Congress without the sound. The sound was on Vitaphone discs that were actually stored away in AT&T's own vaults, and presumably would never be played for the rest of eternity. And so, like a catalytic agent, we came together and brought the Vitaphone discs and the pictures together. We had a remarkable sound engineer work on restoring the quality of the sound, and on August 6th, which was the 50th anniversary itself, we presented the entire program, minus 2 shorts for which the sound is still lost, all over the country.
Western Electric and Bell Labs actually helped develop this whole technique, didn't they?
Yes, that's right. Lee DeForest had devised the three-filament tube, the Audion tube, way back in the early years of the century, and sold the rights to Western Electric around 1913. And Weston Electric pumped the gas out of the tube, made it a vacuum tube, and this was the basic tube that was used in all amplification and made radio possible, the phonograph industry as we know it today, and so on. And in 1925, Weston Electric introduced electric phonograph records. Up to that time, everybody recorded using horns, horns that would have a mica diaphragm at the end and a needle. And it was the sheer din of the sound of the recording voice that made the recording. After 1925, people could walk up to a microphone and coo into it. You see, and crooning was suddenly possible. And that was in the phonograph industry. And then in the film industry, 1 year later, Vitaphone came along. So actually, Weston Electric has played a very, very important part in the history of the development of sound recording.
I understand that the end of Don Juan is quite romantic.
Oh, it's marvelous. It's the most improbable ending of all times. Barrymore rescues Mary Astor from the clutches of the Borgias, played by Warner Oland and Estelle Taylor, and he rides off with her on the horse, and they're trying to escape to Spain from Italy. And the Borgias send their horseback troops, which, of course, have to be vanquished by Barrymore before he can escape. He stashes her in a tree, and then quickly swoops her up, and they ride off literally into the sunset. And of course, there's always thunderous applause every time we show the film, no matter where it is.
Thank you, Miles, for being with us today.
Thank you, Pat.